Hey guys, how you doing? Okay, I've got a request for this video so many times, and I have it on my list, so I figured today I'm just gonna knock it out and get it done. People want to know what to have in their, let's say, we'll call it the bed bag. And it's what it essentially is. It's the bag I take with me when I'm not feeling good and I want to sit on the couch, or you're sitting in bed, or can even be I take to the I have many doctor's appointments and tests and all kinds of that kind of stuff. So, you know, sometimes you end up waiting around a lot. So I take it there with me. You know, sometimes we'll put more in, or it depends on what I'm working on. Now, this is just for drawing and mixed media stuff. I've also gotten actually stuff on clay. So I can do a little video coming up if you guys want. Leave it in the comments of what, if you're a clay person, what to bring with you. Clay is a little harder because there's not, I mean, really, you bring your clay and you build a face. But I find that I like to bring, like if I'm doing a head, I like to have foil as my main component in the middle. So I'll bring clay and then like my foil head and like sit and have baby wipes. And baby wipes would be included in this also. I don't have them here with me, but I'll get to that in a minute. You know, and have a thing of cheap baby wipes you can get at the dollar store or Walmart or wherever. And just to clean your hands off before you obviously go in, because, you know, clay has that feeling, you know, but you can do quite a few things. You can even take your structure, whether you use wire, pipe cleaners or whatever, and start building some structures for your clay for when you get home. But clay can also be done in bed and you can buy one of the very cheap, use your coupon at the Michaels or AC Moore or Joann's or wherever, and buy one of the kid caddies that sit on your bed like a dinner tray. They like sit over your hips, unless you're like me and you have big hips, and then you try to put it on and like you like finally like squish yourself, like you kind of like separate the legs kind of, you know, because it's plastic, but they bow out a little bit and you get it on there. But if you move once, it like pops up and gets off, and it doesn't work for me. But for most other people, it would work. And you use that and use that as your table. And it's, you know, which you can also use for your mixed media. But, you know, this is just to put into a bag. So I have bought, and let me see if I can show you down here. Please don't look. I'm not clean here right now. Oh, just kicked my dog in the head. Okay. I have this tote carrier. And I got it on half off, and it has this great handle that goes up, and it has wheels, so I can take it around with me. Can you see it? It has tons of pockets in it. I really can't get a great view of it, but when I do my, when I finish straightening up my room and all, and I do my video of my whole room, I'll show it better. But this is where I keep like my colored pencils and stuff like that. I have like a glue gun with glue sticks, a pair of scissors, drawing pencils, this and that. This is basically right now where I keep my, you don't need to see my dirty room, where I keep this stuff that I'm going to show you right now. But what I do like is when I go to the doctor's and all and I make my little bag, I either use one of the bags that you can buy from the grocery store, which are like $1.99 or something. You know how they sell those, you know, reusable grocery bags or whatever. You can use an old backpack. You can use anything you have that you can store in. If you don't have anything, use a shopping bag. You can use a brown paper bag or a plastic bag. It doesn't matter. The point is you're able to carry it to where you're at, have all your stuff contained. So you can go as fancy as you want, or you can go, you know, AC Moore sells tote bags, you know, for like $6.99. Use your coupon, get a half off. Like I said, I'm all for, don't go spend any money. Just use a grocery bag if you don't have anything else. You know what I mean? Or if you go to the grocery store, pick up a brown paper bag. It doesn't matter. The point is you want something that's transferable. I do have, like I said, a bag that I pack that I take with me when I go out to doctor's appointments and whatnot. So that's kind of where you know, what I do. So here's what we're going to do. First thing I do is, first thing I pack, I'll show you these in a minute. I bought this sketchbook at Barnes & Noble. I get coupons in the mail. You can sign up online. And I get coupons in the mail, and they were, I guess it was like a 15% off day. It is just a sketchbook. It was $10.95, and they have all colors, and I got like 20%, 15, 20% off of it, or 25, whatever sale they were having. And it's cute. It's just a sketchbook. I've not really done media, like water, you know, or all my mixed media stuff on it. However, I do write my quotes in it that I love when I want to do paintings. This happens to be perforated. I do enjoy perforated things because if I draw in here as I'm sitting down, I rip out if I want to use it on a painting, because these are fine to use on a painting, you know. Now, I would do, these are definitely great for watercolors, you know, with your watercolor pencils, because you're not going to really, you know, do anything major. If you gessoed the page or put a coat down and left it dry and then painted acrylics on top of it, it probably would be fine. I'm always like, you know, if you're going to use this page and you want to do a use it for a mixed media or whatever, and you get one of these books, which I love. Look at all these pages. I mean, it's gazillion. Always put a piece of paper in between. Like, you know, like in between here, get a piece of printer paper, an old piece of paper that you have, piece of cardstock, whatever, put it between here. So when you work, anything that absorbs through will go onto the paper behind it that you have protecting, or even a piece of saran wrap or wax paper, whatever. And then it won't get on the next page. So you can definitely use this as your mixed media watercolor, you know, whatever, draw, you know, journal. It doesn't matter. I love it. So I got this at Barnes & Noble. I will usually, this usually stays around near me. But again, you can definitely take this in your, throw this in your bag, and it goes into your, wherever you go. And that's where you can sit and draw and write your ideas out, or your favorite quote, and think that you want to do a painting and write down your ideas for your painting or your clay or whatever you do. So having a book, and it can be a composition book, you know, the marble black and white composition books you can get very inexpensively. They work great too. And they can, you can use those as your art journals. Okay. So this is a great thing to have. Any kind, any type of book that you have. Oh, here's one of my composition books right here. I knew I had one sitting here. Just a plain old composition book I got from probably Staples or Target or whatever. And you can see I've drawn in here. I've painted. I've ripped a lot of papers out of here that I've done and added onto things and stuff like that. If you don't have, if you're somebody who don't have a lot of extra, what are they called? Ephemera? Like little stickers and papers and stuff. Just sit and draw and doodle. And this is another great thing I'm going to show you in a minute. But just sit and you know, draw your butterflies and or, you know, hearts or whatever you like to doodle. Just little doodles. And then color them in. And then you can cut them out and use them on your mixed media piece. So this is 99 cents probably. And you can get these anywhere. So this composition book would be great. Just as great to throw in there. To draw on, to write your ideas on, to do your watercolor on, it doesn't matter. Okay? And I promise you this week we will make our journals. I've had a lot going on, so I'm trying to keep everything. That's why sometimes you get two videos a day, because I have such a list of things that people want to see and that want done, and I want to try to hit all of them, because some of them are for Christmas gifts and ideas and stuff, and I want to make sure I get it done in time. So you can definitely just use your composition book. This one's a fancy, you know, funky one. But you can get the black and white one composition book. And you can, which is fun to do. I've seen people do it before, and then we can cover this and make it our own cover. You know what I'm saying? So we can do a lot of fun with that. So that might be one of the ways we play, you know, we pick for our journal. And I would probably just show you this and say, hey, let's paint it and cover it up and do all this and let's make this a fun journal. And how inexpensive. And like I said, I it's well loved and used. I use it a lot. Okay. So that would be that. What I highly suggest, and these are very inexpensive, you know, like the composition book, very inexpensive. This is a medium-sized mixed media, multimedia book. I got this at AC Moore Michaels with a 40% off coupon. So you could probably get it for $4 or $5, maybe even less. It's a 7x10. It's a great size to put in your thing for, it's about the same size as the composition notebook. To put in your bag. This is a definite something that I would have. I would either have something like this or your composition book, something that you can have that you can draw on and write on. Now, right now, AC Moore has these on sale. They were $5. Now they're $5.80 or something like that. And it's this exact one. And it's at AC Moore. They have a big bin by the every AC Moore, they're moving them all around, but they have a big bin, like you'll see it in the middle and you'll see like a bunch of these and watercolor paper books and all that kind of thing. So check them out, but they're very inexpensive over there now and they're great. You get 60 pages, you know, you get 100 sheets in your composition book that you buy that would probably be a lot cheaper than this, but you want some sort of paper. Once we make our journal, you can just take our journal in there, you know, the journal that you make. If you don't have any of these and money to get any of these, printer paper will work just as well. If you have printer paper, I highly suggest that if you can't find these, you can't afford these, but you want something more sturdier than printer paper, go buy with your coupon white cardstock from AC Moore or Michaels. Use your coupon and you could get it for $2. You get like 100 sheets and it's a much thicker than your composition book. And it takes everything fairly well. And you can use that also. So those are great things. So have some sort of tablet or composition book or paper in your thing with you. So when you're sitting in bed, you have obviously something to work on. I'm going to leave this here for a second. Now, you want a pair of scissors. Any scissors will do. I like to have a small pair like this. These are, I don't even know, Color B. I don't even know what these are, so old. But, you can get these at the dollar store. You just want a smaller pair. You don't want to have a big clunky pair in your, you know, your bag or whatever you have that you're taking. So you want to have a small pair of scissors. If all you have is a big clunky pair and you don't want to go out and buy a new pair, then use the big clunky pair. I just had to use my zigzag scissors that I use for sewing on something to cut because I don't know what I did with all my scissors because I pick up and as I cut things, I walk away. And then I lay them down wherever because I'm so, I'm just cool like that. And then I lose everything. But these are just a small pair and you can get, you know, you can get them. And like I said, look, you can see like the tips worn off and there's paint all over them and glue. And, you know, so depending on, you know, how much you want to spend on scissors, a new pair of scissors from the dollar store are perfect. And whatever you have at home is perfect. You don't, you know, these, it's not a big deal. So this is a great thing to have in your bag. Another great thing is, and you can get this at the dollar store, a ruler. Any type of ruler. Like I said, you can get them at the dollar store. You can get them at, you know, Staples and Office Depot and all them. You know, you can get them everywhere. This one I got from AC Moore. And it was probably cheap as balls. It was probably like $1, maybe even less. And I liked it because it's a wooden ruler, but like these are plastic. So when I do my edges, I don't know if you can see how well you can see, but the plastic goes over the wood. So when you draw with it, You're not getting the wood. You're getting a nice straight, you know, straight line. So this is, you know, this is a very inexpensive AC Moore ruler. And this is a must have in your bag. Now, of course, you got to have your watercolor pencils. Any brand will do. Crayola. I have Crayola ones that I have in my bag over there. I have Reeves. I have, you know, all kinds of different brands. I like the Crayola ones. I like these ones. I think they're awesome. And so whatever you have, and if you don't have and you need to buy, like I said, you can buy these Reeves at Michael's or AC Moore, Joann's, wherever, or just go to the big old Crayola section. Take your coupon and buy, you know, their watercolor. I advise their watercolor paints, which mine are over on the other side of the room. I forgot to grab them. But watercolor paints, which is a definite to have in your thing. Crayola work great. And if you want your Crayola watercolor pencils or Reeves, whatever. And also I suggest, which I would have to pull out my whole thing there. I don't think I have. Oh, you're not going to believe I just found my green. I just found my green thing. That is too funny. I can't. I looked everywhere there and could not find him. Oh my God, wait till I tell my husband. He's going to be like, that's so typical you. Look how filthy it is. Can you see? I can't believe I just found it. I mean, that's pretty gnarly dirty. You can tell which ones I use a lot of. And I'm going to show how to use these in a minute. I mean, this is so well loved. I love it, love it, love it. How freaking cool. I'm so excited. So now I can keep one. I'm going to keep my brand new one in my bag. And then this will be my travel one because this is the one. I can't believe it. Is it the same one? No, actually, is it the same one? No. No, is this a different? I mean, it has the same circles, but it's like made a little bit differently. Like this one has bigger circles on it than mine. But it has the same ones that I can use. How funny. Oh my God. So this will go into my bag. I can't believe I just found this after I've been going nuts for 2 weeks. Anyway, this is great to have. And I'm going to show you why in a few minutes. And like, you know, if you can have two, that's fantastic. Or you could be like me and just, I've had one for a couple years. And I've used it. Like I said, you could see paint on. I mean, I've used this thing. This thing is so friggin' loved. And not only that, it also works as if you want to spray in it or do paint or whatever. Oh, my gosh. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Okay. So that goes with the other thing. We'll explain that in a minute. So now we have our Crayola watercolor pencils, our Crayola watercolor paints. And now go pick up a thing or take with you regular colored pencils. I have Crayola Crayola colored pencils. I have Reeves colored pencils. I have Prismacolor colored pencils. So what I would do is I've shown you these are all my Prismacolors. I've taken them out of the containers and all. I can't stand it. I like to put them in a nice big Ziploc bag. It's easier for me to carry around. So if I'm in the mood, if I'm in the house, I'll throw these in my bag to go wherever I'm going to go and color and all. If I'm going out, I will just take my regular Crayola colored pencils or whatever kind of colored pencils that you have. If you want to take your business, by all means. I mean, I've thrown them in before, but take a thing of colored pencils with you. So as of right now, we have colored pencils. Use watercolor pencils. Use Crayola or whatever brand you have, watercolor paints, a ruler, some sort of tablet, and your scissors. Okay? So far, that's what we're having. Also, what I like to bring with me is, and I have these in Crayola as well as a million other brands, but Crayola is in my take with me thing. But sometimes I'll grab other brands. You know what I mean? It depends on what I'm working on. You want some colored markers. So you can buy anything from Crayola markers to Bic markers to Sharpies. Remember, Bic and Sharpies are alcohol ink markers. Don't forget. So you don't just have to have your Copics. Spectrum Noir, right now at AC Moore, they're having like wicked sales on them. And they come like 3 or 4 in a pack. So you can get quite a bit if you need them. You know, so there's many options for your colored markers. I'm trying to think what else. But so yeah, and then you want a package of, you can go to the dollar store and get a package of cheap baby wipes, or go to your drugstore, Walmart, or wherever you get them. Just buy a cheap small package of them, throw them in your bag. You have them all the time. You have them to help blend when you're doing your watercolors or whatever. You have them to wipe your hands off. You have them, you just have them for emergency. Now, the next things, speaking of watercolor things, these tend to be expensive. These are the watercolor brushes. You can look online on Amazon and you can get like a pack of 6 of these for like inexpensive. However, when you do that, they get you on shipping and you spend probably, I think it was $2 more, because I was going to order them, but shipping was $2 more than it was for me to buy these online. And I said, forget it. So I use a coupon, and when I go to Michael's or AC Moore, and I will just use a coupon and buy another one. And that's what I do. I only have like 2 or 3. And I want to buy more, but I just have been buying other things with my coupons and really not done that yet. But these are great because you fill it up with water before you go, and then you use your watercolor set or your, and I think I've shown you this all before, we'll just pretend this is any watercolor set that we have. And go with some orange, squeeze a little bit of water out on this. And then here you go. And if we were using my template that I love so much, like I said, this acts as 2 different things. Let me come down just a little bit. You know, I go in, and if you're starting a mixed media piece and you're doing, you know, you're doing whatever with your colored pencils and your watercolor pencils, you can use your watercolor paints. Go in and get a couple circles going. Even the little circles, little dots. You know, you're big. And it just gives you another mixed media piece to use. Now, obviously, I pulled it away too fast because it kind of smeared. But you get my drift. So, you know, then you just squeeze out your brush and on a back, a different page, and you start another mixed media page until your brush is kind of clean. And then you put the lid back on, and you've got a whatever kind of watercolors you have, and you have your water brush, and you're good to go. And this also works with your watercolor pencils. So that is an more expensive item than I would suggest, that I would normally suggest to you. However, I love these. These are so great because when you're in bed and you want to paint, or you want to paint a picture, or just doodle, or use your watercolor pencils or your watercolor paints, or even watercolor markers like the aqua markers, or even Crayola markers, they're all water soluble. So when you use it, you know, you use your marker and then you take your water and you can blend and do all kinds of fun things. This is really worth getting the coupon and getting one of these. You can go on HobbyLobby.com and they have coupons on there. Same with Joann.com. And you can look these up and just buy a nice, you know, a nice medium size nib brush. You get all of this together. You just unscrew this. And you see this little thing here, you hold it under running water or stick it in your water, squeeze it, you know, you squeeze it, it fills this whole thing up. You screw it back on. And you're ready to go. So if when you come home from wherever you go, or if you do this in bed or on the couch or whatever, and you've used this, make sure you fill this up to put it back into your thing, because there's nothing worse than going and getting in bed, getting set up and going to grab your thing, and you have 2 squirts of water left in this. So always try to make that a habit. So this is a definite. I know it's a tad bit expensive. It might be $4 or $5 with your coupon, but it's so worth just to have one, because it'll make your life so much easier that you can do these things in bed. Okay, so that's that. I also highly suggest, and these are only a dollar something at Michael's. These are jelly rolls, and from Sakura. And this is their, this is a jelly roll medium. I don't know what that means, but it's white. Does this say what size it is? No. 06, whatever that means. Anyway, these are fantastic. They're jelly rolls that you can write over. Look, we can write over. Well, that's still a little wet. But, and then we have our white. I was using this last night, so it's kind of. And when you're done using it, no matter where you're using it, roll the tip on something so it cleans it off so it doesn't dry. But look, it'll go. Everything's kind of wet still, so it's kind of. I don't have any black paper here. Let's see if I can show you on here. Yeah. See? Writes beautifully. Now, these are $1.29 or something like that a piece. I have quite a few of them. Are they a necessity? No. Do I suggest them? Yes. I suggest to put them in your thing, and I'm going to tell you why. When you go and you do your drawing, or you just want to sit and I've shown different things of mixed media that I do. You want to go in and do some doodles around some of the things that you did, or doodle inside, or do you know what I mean? Make markings, make it around your page, whatever. These are fantastic. And really for a dollar something a piece. And they have every color under the sun. So, hey, go for it if you want them. But black and white are what I suggest, highly suggest. And they just are an extra added thing. If you don't have them and you don't think that you will really dig them, don't get them. That is just my suggestion. Something I do love is a good mechanical pencil. And because I have RA and fibro and many problems with my hands, this is a Papermate Clear Point. This is a 0.7. I don't like to use 0.5s. I like 0.7s or 0.9s because the lead's thicker and I have a tendency to break things. And it has a cute little clicky click right here for the lead. And you can put your lead in it. And it's thicker on the bottom, so I don't have as much fatigue in my hands when I draw. And it has an eraser, which I hardly ever use. But it comes with extra erasers and lead, obviously, and I always pick up an extra. I think if you go to Staples, you can buy this, and it comes with an extra container of lead and eraser. So it's a really great deal to throw the whole thing in your bag. But this is what I like to draw with. But usually I'll pick up whatever's around me. But this is what I love to have in my case. And, you know, it's just really, it's a nice lead. If you get a 0.9, the lead's a little thicker. And if you're heavy-handed and break lead a lot, that would be what I suggest for you, because I love the nines. And it'll be a little darker, a little thicker, but it doesn't matter. So these I love. And especially if you have carpal tunnel, anything wrong with your hands or your hands get fatigued very quickly, I love it because it's thick. And it's not too thick, because I bought ones that were like wicked thick thinking, oh, that's going to be great. Made my hands more tired than if I would have used a teeny little weenie pencil. So this is just a Papermate, you know, thing. Now, this is the Faber-Castell Dust Free. This you can get at Michael's and at AC Moore. And let me just show you how great it erases. We're going to do some squiggles. And what it does is it takes all those little, I don't know how it does it. It's fancy. And look, it makes them into like little, I don't want to say boogers, but that's what it looks like. I'm sorry. I'm such a child. Look, that's what it makes it into. So if you're in bed or on the couch, who the hell wants, you know, to use an eraser that causes, what the heck was that that dropped? That causes all these. Watch, this is the difference of the erasers. Can you see the difference? that's what I just erased. This belongs over there. That's what I just erased, all those crumbs. And imagine erasing a big thing. And this is, so you see the difference. It's a big difference. It makes a difference when you're working in your bed or on the couch. So if you don't have this and can't afford it, I'm thinking about doing a giveaway and getting one to go with the round template, which I'm going to show you in a minute. It's fantastic, dust-free. You see what it does. It will sit. I mean, you will be. You might look at this and be like, "Ah, who needs it?" I'm going to tell you, when you get it, you're going to like call me and you're going to say, "Guess what? You're the best in the world. You're better than chocolate and pretzels and peanut butter and potato chips on my PMS time." I'm telling you, that's what you're going to say. Because it is the greatest thing. I even have another one that's fantastic. It's called, it's expensive. It's a 4-in-1 eraser. And it's called Vanish. And you can only get it, I think, online. And it does the same kind of thing. It doesn't give you any crumbs. Like, it's, see it? It's like right here. It's like this little teeny thing. And it's fantastic. But I have to see if I can get that. I think I can only get that online. I don't think I can get that in the store. I have to look. One or the other of these I'm going to do as a giveaway because they are both fantastique. Okay. Now, I always suggest you need a black marker and a light brown marker. Any kind will do. If you have a Sharpie, you want the finer point, though. You want a fine point. So the lines like that. Okay. And this one has a double side, which these are the best because you have, you can see I was writing with that one, because you have the finer point and then you have the thicker point. And those are great because, and if you can find a brown one like that too, that are permanent, these are waterproof permanent archival ink. So once they dry, so if you're sketching them or you do your eyes or whatever, I usually hit it with a heat gun to make sure it's dry all the way through the paper, but they're permanent. So they won't smear. So if you draw and you're in bed or on the couch or whatever, and you go to use your watercolor pencils or watercolor things or markers, it won't smear your ink that you drew with the eyes. So that's why I usually do a quick once over when I draw my eyes to sketch over and then color everything. And then we'll go over to really get that cleaner, sharper line with the markers. But you definitely got to have a black and a light brown marker. Now, this is my little Faber-Castell bag, and you can buy this as a kit. This is not definitely needed, but if you are somebody who likes to not so much paint in your faces or whatever, these are all the different, like H2B, 4H, like all the different lead, you know, thicknesses. You know, some are dark, see how dark that one is. This is a HB, and you can see this one is a 4H. Can you see the difference? It's just, they're just different thicknesses of their lead and all, and they're great for if you're a sketch, you know, you like to do black and white graphite drawings and stuff, and they're great, and then you have your little snub to, I think I have one in my next thing. So this is great. You can buy this as a kit. This is not a necessity at all. It's just a little pouch where I keep them all at and keep in my thing. Now, this is my pouch. Now, everybody has, you can go to the dollar store and buy yourself a pencil case. I have a couple around here somewhere that I have. But anyway, you can buy a pencil case. So in my pencil case, this actually came in the pencil case, most of the stuff. This is one of those things that if we're going to do an eye, like say, see how I have my line, like let's say I draw my line here and then I'm going to put my line on there. Now I can see that's obviously not straight, my line, but if it was, then you can kind of see where you want your eye, where you want your lines to be. It kind of helps you like square things up. Not necessary. It came in the package. But these can be helpful because you see that there's like your one eye would go here. Then here's your space where you would skip it. And then the next line would go here. So you have perfect. Then your nose and then your lips. So it is a nice kit to get. You know, and it helps you make sure that everything's straight. This is a little protractor thing, and this again helps draw straight, and you can measure. This came in the kit. This is my one of my favorite pens. It's a black marker. It's a R2.7 rollerball. I don't exactly know, but I love drawing with it. That I got myself. Oh, you know what I have? I could probably give one of these away. This one's not never been used. Never been used, rather. Yeah, I must have went crazy and bought a package. Because I have these two in here, and then I have that one there, and I have another one in my thing. So, yeah, I do have one to give away. Awesome. Okay. Then this is another eraser. This came in it. It's an artist drawing eraser. Comes in the package. You always want your pencil sharpener. Like I said, I always have this in mind because it has two holes. Because sometimes you find pencils are different things and different widths. And you need both of those. And you always end up only having one. Wait, 1 second. Dave? Can you let him out, let James out? So you want to do that. You want to make sure you have a good pencil sharpener. All right. Put my erasers back in there. My pen. Like I said, I keep these in here just because you never know when you're going to need something to do a straight line. This is fantastic, and I'll show you what this is in a second. This is a blender stump. So if you want to blend, look at that, how it blends when you're using your different leads. And if you're just drawing, which we can do a couple of those. I'm not really great at just the graphite drawing, but with the shading, but we could play. And these are great. And you see how it just, look. It just shades that out. So imagine doing a face and then doing this, and then you can shade, you know, the eyes and do all that kind of thing. Let's see. Got our eye. I mean, very fun. These are just options. These are not things that you must have. But look at that. That's a great eye. That's a great eye. So, okay. So that's that. This is my white. It's just a white colored pencil. And it like seals things for me. So like if I go to put gesso over this, it won't smear. I've done that forever. Sounds silly. It doesn't necessarily change the color of anything. It just kind of protects what's underneath. So, but here's what I suggest. And then I'll go, I know I'm being like sporadic everywhere. This, it is a pencil extender. And if I could tell you, you know, you saw my Pup Color pencils, right? And this is any pencil. Everybody has a favorite kind of pencil. It could be a drawing pencil. It can be whatever. Where's that little stinking pencil? I probably won't even be able to find it. We'll just pretend like this is it. Your pencil starts getting small and snubby. Stubby. It could be any kind of pencil. Watercolor, writing pencil, colored pencil. This. You move that thing. And you can buy these separately. You put your pencil in here. You put that down until it gets tight. And now your pencil's a bigger pencil. Now it's usually for when it's a stub. But now, look. So when your pencil gets smaller, like down to here, I'm like, shoot, I'm gonna get paid for another 2 weeks and I wanna use my pencil. You just put the extender on. How awesome is this? And you can, and you know what else? If you buy the pencil extender, you know how I was telling you guys how to color with the color pencil? You put whatever size color pencil you have in there that you're using, hold it back here and just lightly do it. You will not break your lead or your wax. And look at the great coverage. And it's a very light touch. So that might be something for people who are heavy-handed, because I used to be very heavy-handed. And then I learned, you know, I'm going to throw this in here because I know I have some stubs in there. But that's basically it. And I'm going to go over real quick as a, you know, because I know I'm all over the place, because I always am. You want a good, you want a tablet. You, whether it's a composition notebook, whether it's a journal we make, whether it's a notebook, whether it's a mixed media book, whatever you have, you want one of these for your, whether you have an old backpack, an old purse, shopping bag that you buy at the store, or a shopping bag that you bring your groceries home in, it does not matter. So we want paper. We want our watercolor pencils. We want our watercolor brush. Coupons, use coupons. You want watercolor paints. Crayola are fantastic. You've seen me use them a million times. Also, I'm going to throw this in as a, if you have one. If you have one, throw your Elmer's glue stick or whatever glue stick you have in your package too, because you never know when you might need it. A pencil sharpener, any kind you have. A black and light brown marker. You might already have it. Could be Sharpie, could be whatever. Your ruler. Your mechanical pencil. If you don't have a mechanical pencil, put in your school pencil. A pair of scissors. And I think that's pretty much it. Right? So we can draw. We can cut out. We can color. You can also, which I don't have here with me right now, add your Crayola markers. They are fantastic. Or any type of marker that you have. And add that in here also. And if you like the black and white jelly roll, which I do love, and that's up to you. And this is a great way to sit and start. I sometimes will have a couple of different pencils in there in case I run out of lead. So it's nice to have just a number two pencil or another kind of pencil just in case you need it. And like I said, this is the basic of what you need. And then I would throw in this, which I'm going to show you right now how to use on mine. I'm not going to open this one. Now, if you want, you can put, if you have gelatos and you love gelatos, throw your gelatos in here. I have my gelatos in this white Tupperware container thing, but you can have yours in a baggie. If you want to throw it, these are extras. If you want to, you know what I mean? Because if you want to use those as your watercolor, you sure can. Throw in a couple stamps if you want, because you can definitely use your watercolor markers and your watercolor pencils or paints to use as the thing to stamp on with. Do you know what I'm saying? Like if we did this. I just want to really give you guys an idea. We'll just go on the top here. I'm just going to go into the orange, squeeze a little bit of water. I'm going to take one of these that I made, but you can use whatever you have. And I'm just going to run my brush over them. And this is if you're doing a painting or, you know, you're doing just a lot of people use their mixed media as books or whatever as their art journals. So if you're doing your art journal, you know, and you want a little, you know, so you just want to kind of get that color on there. It's so versatile. Like I said, I know it's expensive to get this water brush and you only need one, but it's so versatile in so many ways and it will help you so much not feel like you can't do anything. Now, if you can take a paintbrush and a cup of water and all and sit in bed and do this, great. But this is great to have all this stuff in your bag. Where do I want to stamp? We'll just stamp here. Why does it matter? And see? So you get, you know, you know what I mean? You get your great stamps. And it could be any stamp, any butt stamp, anything you have. That was just sitting there, you know. And look how nice this paint is and colors. And this could be, like I said, your Crayola, whatever brand that you have. You don't have to spend a lot of money. Just remember to refill this when you're done, because I'm about empty with mine. And I know I'll go to use it and be like, dang it. So those are just some things. Okay, so I hope that that helped you guys out a lot. So you want your tablet, you want your watercolor pencils, your watercolor, which, like I said, Crayola is fantastic. You want your black and brown pen. You want your pencil. Two, I suggest, scissors, any kind of sharpener. I highly suggest this water pen, a ruler, and I think we're pretty good to go. A thing of baby wipes, your colored pencils. Like I said, buy a thing of Crayola colored pencils, or if you have the Prismacolors and all that kind of thing, use them. They're fantastic. Put them in your little bag. If you don't have a little bag, use a plastic shopping bag. I'm all about recycling, so do that. Extra things, like I said, a glue stick and a black and white jelly roll. Necessary? No. It's just something extra. And, you know, a few stamps if you want, because like I said, you can definitely stamp using your water. And if you have your Crayola or whatever brand markers, you know, it's up to you. This is just the basics. So when you go grab that bag, you can draw, you can paint, you can color, you can do whatever. Throw a box of crayons in there. Do whatever you want. And you have the general makings of just picking this up and going and sitting in the bed, doing any of the videos that I do, and enjoying yourself and not feeling, because believe me, I know the same as all. I mean, I get so many messages and emails from you guys. It is horrible to have a bad day, and creating something for 15, 20 minutes can take your mind off of it, and it makes you feel not as worthless. And I love it. I mean, you guys keep me running, but some days I just want to lay in bed and cry all day. I'm not even going to lie to you. And there's days I do. I'm not going to lie. But you know what? Like I said, just having these to grab your bag and go. And if you can afford to buy extras so that you have it in your art room or wherever you work at, and then your extras in your, in your bag, that works out great. Like when you have couple extra bucks, or you can use coupons, or you go to the thrift stores and they have, you know, those kind of things, pick them up and make your bag. So you can have your bag that sits here, or your art items like I have, and then you have your bag to pick up and don't have to worry. Oh, gee, did I put my thing back in there? Or did I do this? Or did I do that? So, also something extra I want to tell you about. These are Moleskine journals. Okay. And these are great. This is the, I don't know what this is. They have different kinds. This is a mixed media one. It's called mixed media, or for watercolor. So the paper's thicker. I mean, So if you have the money, and everyone sells this now, you can get these at AC Moore and Michaels, and you want to make sure you get like a watercolor mixed media one. They have them everywhere. Buy one, use your coupon. And this is great to throw in there rather than even having your big book or whatever, because then you can just work in this. So, and you can see, I don't know what I was playing with stuff and stamped all over it in places, very old. So, you can always get a Moleskine, which is great. I love them. I have many, many of them, but I have many that I've made too. So we'll get there. So I hope this helped you guys. Real quick, I'm going to show you something now. Oh, this is longer than the other one. The people were asking about this, so I'm going to show you real quick. First, I'm going to show you on the grill I did, and then I'm going to show you. Okay. This is what I use this for. I use this to help me do my straight lines when I'm doing my faces. And then when I'm going to do my eyes, my pupil and my color part of my eye, and I just lost the name of it. What I will do is I will go in and use this as my guide to draw my circle. This isn't too bad. But when I go in, then I know my circle is perfect. See, that's not even big enough. And when I'm doing it, I obviously draw it beforehand. But you want, that way you get a perfect circle. And you're not like, because I get sometimes lopsided circles. This one looks like it'll be more. Yeah, that wasn't too bad one. But you can kind of see where the pencil is. So when I'm drawing my face, if I'm doing, we'll just do big eyes here so you guys can see. And these are not going to be perfect and all like angelic looking. So then I'll go in and I'll make her eyeball, which will be pretty big on this one, but I want you guys to be able to see it. So I'll make it in the middle. These have two lines, so you kind of know, you can kind of judge up. And I can see right here that my lines need to meet right here. When I go in, and these ones are pretty good, and then I just draw my circle. And I'll do the same thing over here. I'm not going to worry about the lines meeting up there, just to show you. And I got my eyeballs. Then I'll go in and I'll do my corner to corner, my eyelid. All right, and then we erase this off. This is a big version. This isn't necessarily the version. You know, and then you go in later and fix all your lines that you erased. Then I go in with the smaller one to make my pupil. So then I can kind of line it up to see where I'm at. And then do my pupil. And make sure you always remember which one you're using for the pupil, because I've done that before and had two sized pupils. But I'm just trying to show you here how I use this. And then you have your eyes. So the circles are absolutely, because our eyes are absolutely circular. So sometimes, like I said, now you, once you sit and you really use it, you'll get the gist of like what ones to use and everything like that. And your eyes will be better. I mean, you know, obviously mine will be a lot, you know, yours will be a lot better when you take the time and then you go and you can do your nose, you know, and do what you do. Maybe she has a little teeny mouth. You know, she has some big ass eyes, but you understand what I'm saying. So that's what it's used for. So then I can use this for straightening. Like if I want to make sure that my eyes are the same, you know, like on my page, you know, like one eye's down lower than the other. I use these for my pupils and my circles. I use this for a lot of things. And like I said, I use them for mixed media. This is like my favorite thing in the world. And that's how I started drawing the faces, because a lot of times my eyes would end up like this, where this one's right on spot and this one's not. So then, you know what I mean? So it just helps you out. And like I said, those circles make all the difference when you're making your eyes. I can't tell you that enough. Because if your eyes, as you can see, this is where it says my eye lines should be. Let's see if I can show you. And it just makes it look all proportioned and so much better. I don't even know how well you can see where my pencil lines are. And it just makes it, it'll make it look a little bit better, because, I mean, yeah, you look at it, it's like, oh, it looks all right. But when you do the circle, and I'll see this extra blue wouldn't be there, and then we'd go in with the white. So now I know where my circles are. And when I go in to put the white in for my eyes, I can go around that blue and around my circles, and her eyes will become much more shapely. It also helps when you're doing, there's a trick to doing lips. I don't use it too often anymore, but the trick is you have your line and you take, I'll use this one right here. Let's see our line. All right. So you'll draw two circles, so keep the same circle. You want it to touch when you move it over. So you have two circles, and then underneath would be
an oval. And I'm doing this fast, so excuse me. So when you go to do your lips, this is your, that little like dippy part. And you do your lips down like this. And this is your down part like this. And then you'll go down to this part. And then you'll go down. So that oval is your guide. And so are these circles. I have the worst pencil in the world right now working with me. That's why I hate regular pencils. I love mechanical pencils. Okay, so you see how we have our lips. And then what you do is, and then your dip would be right here. So you can see the circle. You would like kind of connect it, but I'm not going to teach you all that right now. But anyway, so erase your two circles and erase that little oval on the bottom. And you can make your dip as dippy as you want it. Doesn't matter. And then just go in this freaking pencil and do your little thing, and you have your lips. So there's different ways to do, like I said, this is not perfect, but there's different ways to use this to your advantage to draw a face. Next, maybe one video I'll do it and I'll use it through the whole thing and show you all the advantages and how to do, you know, your lips. And like I said, this would be more of a, you want it to be a little wider. You know, I get obsessive, but anyway, so I could show you how to use this to really, really improve your drawing. This is done because I'm in a hurry and I don't want to keep you guys much longer. So, but that's kind of where we're at. So that's what we're packing. This is where we're at. And the next video up will be, what will it be? I have a quickie coming up on how to make texture with things from home, with cardboard. It goes with my texture on, remember we made our stamps on the cardboard, and we made our stamps on fun foam, and so our next in the series is coming up with more cardboard and a few more things, and that it's just going to be a quickie. And somebody had asked me to do it. A few people asked me to do it, actually. And we're going to do that next, and that'll be a very quickie. I'll have most of them set up and ready to go and just kind of talk you through it, and that'll be it. So look for our mixed media. I got my cardboard, our Christmas mixed media. Yeah, my cardboard's drying. I got my piece of regular paper over it. It's a little wrinkled because that's how it came in there. I'm not worried about it. I got it glued on, waiting for it just to finish up, and I'll cut off the papers. And I'm excited to get to that. So I hope this, guys, that this helped you. I hope this helped you a little bit, me explaining it. I had to be kind of quick because I hate being so long. But this has such use. And the other one, like I said, that I'm going to be giving away has even bigger circles. So, I mean, you know, if you're using this as a mixed media piece, also, like with your paints and your markers and just adding stuff, you know, it's great. Also, and like I said, I use it for faces, and it makes all the difference in the world. So I'm so happy I found it. Okay, guys, be kind to each other. You never know what battle somebody's fighting. Tomorrow by noon, we will have a winner for the resin and the amazing clear class cast and the mold putty. And then we will be on our Christmas canvas, and we got a lot of good fun things coming up. So don't blow away if you're as windy and cold as it is here in Jersey. I hope you guys stay safe, and give me a thumbs up if you like our what to put in your bag. And you know, and if you came across me, I just lost train of thought, if you came across me by accident, please like and subscribe. I love getting new people. I love teaching, and I love doing giveaways so people can get inspired. And I love helping people who are like me, who sometimes have to kind of sit and not able to
maybe move out of bed or can't sleep or sit on the couch or do whatever, to have their little bag to take with them wherever they go that they can still create. And I love it. So keep tagging me with all your work, and I will see you again soon. Bye, guys.